Hello students, children. Today I am going to discuss with you the story of this chapter, that is Tarot's Reward, class 6. So students, if you have purchased your books, you can keep the text with you, or I have already sent the text of this chapter to you, and you I hope that you all have gone through the text. So you have got a rough idea of the story, but now I am going to discuss it with you in detail. So Tarot's Reward. So Tarot is the name of the main character of this story, and the story is a Japanese folk tale. This is a story of Japan. It is a Japanese folk tale. Okay, folk tale means lok gatha. Stories, a tale is a story. So it is a Japanese folk tale, and Tarot is a Japanese character. So main character of the story is Tarot, and the whole story revolves around him only. While discussing the chapter, you will come to know about some qualities of Tarot. If you get a question in the paper, like write the character sketch of Tarot, that if you will listen to my video very carefully, then you will be able to write the character sketch of Tarot very, very easily. Okay, so Tarot is a young woodcutter. This is the first character trait of Tarot, that which profession he is doing. That is, Tarot is a young woodcutter, and he is a young boy, and his parents are very old. They were aged. Okay, and his father one day wished to take sake. Now this, you will not pronounce it as sake. The pronunciation of this word is sake. Sake. Okay. Now, sake is a very expensive drink which Japanese people used to take during winters, because this drink make them feel cozy. Okay, and it is very expensive. Expensive means it's very costly, and Tarot was a woodcutter and he was very poor also. You see, a woodcutter cannot be very rich. He can't be very rich. So he doesn't have much money to purchase sake, because sake was very expensive. So this Tarot was a thoughtful son. Thoughtful son means a son who thinks about his parents, who is concerned for his parents, who think for the comfort of his parents. He was very sad because he was just thinking that how he would be able to purchase sake for his father. And he was very good and kind also. That was why he was thinking about his parents. If he would not have been a good person, he would never have thought about his parents. So one morning he went to the forest chopping woods, and suddenly what happened, he heard the sound of a waterfall and he went there. Suddenly a sound of the waterfall came to him from some direction of the this forest, and you see, when he went there, he saw a waterfall, and that waterfall was not there before. Okay, so he went there, and he was also feeling thirsty by cutting the wood, so he just tried to sip the water from the waterfall. But to his surprise, he was surprised to see what? He was surprised that he got sake there. That whole waterfall was of sake, and he was very much surprised. He was amazed, and what he did? He filled his pitcher. Pitcher means his pot, which he used to carry with him for water while cutting woods in the forest. And he filled his pitcher and he hurriedly returned home, and he gave sake to his father. And his father was very much delighted, and what he did, he just got up and he started dancing here and there. And then suddenly a lady from his village came to Tarot's home to visit them. She was a visitor, and Tarot was a very simple man. Here you come to know that he was very simpleton. Okay, he was hardworking. He was very simpleton. What he did, he offered this this sake to that lady also. A lady was very much surprised that this family is very poor and how come they have this sake, so expensive drink. And then she asked him that how did he manage to get sake. And Taro was very simple person, so he told the whole story to that woman that in this forest he had seen a waterfall and there he got the sake from that waterfall. And then next the lady spread this news of sake. She spread the news in all the whole of the village, and the villagers went there. All the villagers went there to with their vessels to have that sake. And when they went there, they just got simple water. They get simple water there. They thought that Taro had deceived them. Deceived means unko jaise dhoka mila hai. They just come to know, they thought that Taro deceived them and they decided to beat Taro. But Taro came to know about their plan and he hid himself behind the rock. And when all the villagers went away, he again came out of behind the rock, and then he again went to the waterfall and tasted the water, and it was sake. That magical waterfall gave sake to Taro only, not to any other person. Why? Because of his love for his parents, because of his sincerity and his love for his parents. And then the story spread that the waterfall gave sake only to Taro. And the story reached the emperor. Emperor means the king of that place, and he rewarded Taro. How he rewarded Taro? He king gave him 20 pieces of gold and named the most beautiful fountain in the city after Taro. Means he gave that most beautiful fountain the name of Taro. So this was the reward which Taro received because of his love, his sincerity towards his parents, his nature of hard working. So he was really a very, very good person. So the message of this story is that we should love our parents, we should obey our parents, and we should be sincere for our parents. We should be hard working also. We should be good and kind, because all these qualities are always rewarding. They give, they pay a person in the long run of life. So this was the message which the writer or which the story writer want to convey from this story. It is a moral value based story. So children, now I hope that the discussion of this story or this chapter today is going to be very helpful. If you have any queries, you can send your queries through WhatsApp groups also, and you can also post comments. I will try my best to give you satisfactory answers. Thank you, children.